One of the unsolved puzzles of astrobiology is, how did life originate? Where did the building blocks for life come from? The central conundrum that astrobiologists face in trying to address this question is, how do we go from basic molecules to a self-replicating microorganism? And I should say right from the beginning, we don't know the answer to this problem, but many significant strides have been made by astrobiologists in understanding where those building blocks came from and how they might have been assembled into the earliest life forms. So there are several possibilities for how life might have originated, and here are three of them. The first one is some supernatural or divine intervention. Life was created by some supernatural force. Well, whether you believe that or not, it doesn't get us very far. It doesn't explain how the building blocks of life were created and how they might have assembled into the early living organisms on the Earth. So even if you were to believe this, it doesn't get away from the central astrobiological problem of understanding those building blocks. Another response to how did life originate might be it originated elsewhere and was transferred to the Earth, maybe on comets or in asteroid impacts. This is a possibility. We can't prove at the current time that life originated on the Earth, but it still doesn't get us away from the problem of how did life originate in that distant location. Now, of course, there's a problem there, because if it originated on a planet with very different conditions, there may have been conditions on some distant world that were much more conducive to the origin of life. But without the ability to test that at the current time, without the ability to find other planets and prove that life originated there, we're left with our final possibility, and that's that life originated on the Earth. And it's that assumption that we use in trying to understand the origin of life, and at least to constrain the sorts of experiments that astrobiologists do in trying to understand how building blocks were assembled for early life and how they came together. So the first question we might ask as astrobiologists is, where did the building blocks of life come from? And we've seen in an earlier lecture that life is constructed from building blocks such as amino acids and sugars. One of the earliest experiments to look at where the building blocks of life might have come from was carried out by Harold Urey and Stanley Miller in 1952, and it's really become an iconic experiment. In the design of this experiment, they take a container with water and they boil that water, and the water travels through a tube into another container that contains a simulated early Earth atmosphere. And that atmosphere has methane, hydrogen, carbon monoxide and ammonia, and across that chamber they have an electrical discharge that puts energy into the gases. And these chemical reactions occur as the gases are electrified through this discharge and as the water passes through them. They carried out this experiment, and after a few days and weeks they found the production of yellow substance, almost a tarry substance, in their experiment. And they removed that substance and analysed it, and they found that it contained amino acids as well as other complex chemical compounds. This experiment showed that you could potentially create the building blocks of life, amino acids, the building blocks of proteins, in simple experiments such as this. Well, nowadays we know that the early Earth's atmosphere was slightly different from the atmosphere used by Urey and Miller. We think it was less reducing. In other words, it had less of the compounds ammonia, hydrogen, carbon monoxide. It may have been more oxidizing, more content of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. But nevertheless, this experiment was really a turning point in astrobiology, because for the first time, it allowed us to think about the creation of these, the formation of these building blocks of life in simple chemical reactions. It turns out that amino acids are really everywhere in the universe. We find them in meteorites that land on the surface of the Earth. This is an image of the Murchison meteorite that landed in the Earth in the late 1960s, and it was found to contain amino acids, aspartic acid, glutamic acid, and many other types of amino acids that are used in biology as the building blocks of proteins. It turns out that these meteorites also contain amino acids that are not used by biology, non-biological amino acids. It seems that life has selected a subset of the available amino acids to be found in the extraterrestrial environment. And since this early work, many other meteorites, carbonaceous chondrites, have also been found to have amino acids, suggesting that these are common constituents of extraterrestrial material. What does all this tell us? It tells us that the building blocks of life could have been produced on the Earth endogenously in chemical reactions on the surface of the early Earth. And it also tells us that the building blocks of life could have arrived on the Earth in extraterrestrial materials, in meteorites. So we have two sources of the building blocks of life for early chemical reactions. Amino acids are the building blocks of proteins, and that's significant if you think that the early history of life began with proteins building up into cellular materials and finally into life. Another question is, where do nucleic acids come from, such as DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, that we talked about in earlier lectures as the information storage system of life? Well, there's another type of nucleic acid called RNA, ribonucleic acid. It's very much like DNA. Instead, the thymine of that four-letter code in DNA is replaced by uracil. It has a four-letter code, adenine, guanine, uracil, and cytosine. These four letters come together in a chain, a bit like DNA, and form these strands of RNA. RNA is a very interesting molecule because it seems to be a little bit more primitive than DNA. But what's particularly interesting about RNA is it can self-assemble into molecules called ribozymes. And these ribozymes can carry out chemical reactions, even including self-replication. And one idea is that the early life on Earth began from RNA, an RNA world, as it's been called. These RNA molecules would have been floating around, perhaps in pools of water on the early Earth, carrying out chemical reactions, replicating and leading to early genetic systems, which would have eventually transitioned to more complex chemical systems and eventually to early cells. One of the questions that astrobiologists address is which came first, a protein world, proteins constructed from these building blocks of amino acids that may have come from space or endogenously produced in environments on early Earth, or did life start in this RNA world produced from these early nucleic acids? Well, it may well be that both came together. Perhaps proteins and RNA were necessary to construct the earlier cells, and these reactions were occurring at the same time. This is one of the questions that astrobiologists are currently seeking to address. What were the earliest molecules that led to the earliest forms of chemistry that led to early life forms, and in what sort of environments were these molecules produced? We saw that in an earlier lecture, we need the building blocks of life, amino acids to build proteins, nucleotides to build nucleic acids. But we also saw that life needs membranes in order to create cells. And one question is, how do you get membranes? Membranes would have been very important for early life on Earth to enclose those early chemical systems, prevent them from dissipating into the environment, simply becoming diluted in the early oceans or early water bodies on the Earth. How would these early chemistries have been enclosed in membranes? Well, experiments studying the production of early membranes have shown that you can produce membranes very, very easily. Scientists have taken materials from simulated interstellar ices and even materials directly from meteorites. And they've added these materials to water and found that membranes can spontaneously form from the lipids inside these materials. It turns out that meteorites contain lipids. And these lipids, when they're added to water, the tails of the lipids are attracted towards each other. The heads of the lipids, which are hydrophilic, they like water, are attracted towards the water, and you get the spontaneous formation of vesicles in water, early membranes, which could have enclosed early chemical reactions on the early Earth. So in a very simplistic way, we could think some sort of scheme of meteorites coming in from space and other types of material, landing in the early oceans and dissipating in the water, and perhaps chemical reactions on the early Earth as well, forming lipids that spontaneously form membranes, vesicles in which chemical reactions could occur. Amino acids formed from early chemical reactions on the Earth and also brought in by meteorites would have provided the building blocks for early proteins, and other chemical reactions could have provided the early building blocks for sugars and nucleic acids, RNA and eventually DNA. And in these sorts of environments, these materials would have assembled to form the early cells. Well, of course, you can tell by the way I say that, it's very hand-waving and very speculative. In truth, we really don't know how these membranes and these early building blocks came together to form a self-replicating cell. It's one thing to create a membrane and to use that membrane to enclose some basic chemical reactions. But going from that to an organism that's self-replicating that looks something like the bacteria or archaea that we're familiar with on today's Earth is another matter altogether. And it remains one of the great challenges in astrobiology to understand that transition from the chemical world to the biological world. So what have we learned in this lecture? We've learned that the building blocks of life can be produced in simulated early Earth conditions. We've also learned that those building blocks can be found in extraterrestrial materials. So they could have been produced on the early Earth, they also could have been delivered to the surface of the early Earth in extraterrestrial materials. We've also learned that primitive membranes that can enclose chemical reactions necessary for the first cells to form can be easily made in the laboratory from simple molecules, even meteoritic materials, and simulated materials formed on interstellar ices. But we've also learned that the order of the emergence of the building blocks is not known. But what is important is that astrobiology has now at least identified plausible sources of these early building blocks and some of the processes by which they may have come together and led to the first life forms on Earth.